In this video, I am going to explain biomechanical relationship among temporomandibular joint, head, and cervical spines. This relationship is so important to understand neck pain, headache, temporomandibular joint dysfunction. This relationship is freaking important. You shouldn't see this relationship as one structure. Everything is connected. Okay, when you chew, when you eat, of course, your jaw joint should move here. This is joint between mandible and temporal bone. This is head, okay? Your jaw is connected to head, okay? Like this. When you eat, your head should be included, okay? Now, this temporal bone is connected to occiput. It's very close to back of the head, right here. What is beneath occipital bone? There is cervical spines. So, if you have a difficulty of chewing, eating, maybe your cervical spine is tight. When you eat, your neck muscle should be reacting. Very tiny, very minute, but you should not ignore this relationship. When you eat, bite, your cervical spines and occiput, temporal bone, should be interrelated, okay? You see this relationship? So movement of jaw, head, and cervical spine is so important. Now, you see real person. There is mandible, temporomandibular joint, temporal bone, occiput, and cervical spines. None of these places should not be tight. Let me rephrase. Every single structure should be flexible, should be independent. Now they should be move as one unit. Okay, let's see. Neck extension, it's very nice. Open mouth, please. Close. I feel tightness around here. It's about sternocleidomastoid. Sternocleidomastoid. Do you know where its attachment is? It's mastoid process. Mastoid process is part of temporal bone. Yay! Temporal mandibular joint. It connects to temporal bone. There's mastoid process. This is also part of temporal bone. You see this relationship? Everything is connected around this area. So when this part gets tight, maybe your chewing movement is inhibited because of this, the chain of connection. Good. Extension is good. Of course, I worked on sternocleidomastoid. Open mouth, please. It's nice. There's flow of movement here. And if I go one more thing, there is the swallowing muscles beneath mandible. When this place gets tight, that inhibits jaw movement. It inhibits here, inhibits here, inhibits here, inhibits here. That affects whole part of neck, head, and jaw. You should not separate these places. These should move as one unit. So when people complain headache, neck pain, of course you should focus here, but maybe you want to focus on jaw because it's connected to head. Head is connected to cervical spines. Good. This person is very flexible, but when you think about your patient, clients whose neck is very tight, head is tight, jaw is tight, maybe their relationship is aggravated. Okay, this is very important, interesting place. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.